If you're thinking about trying out Kinsta, this is the video for you. I've been using it to host one of my websites for the past 4 months, and in this video, I'll share everything you guys should know before you decide whether or not you want to sign up too. I'll go over their features, what I liked about Kinsta, but I'll also tell you about some issues that I found while using it. So if you're interested, stick around until the end of this video. And if at any point while watching this video, you do decide to try out Kinsta, there's a link in the video description below that's going to get you a really nice discount. I used it when I first signed up, so feel free to use that link too if you want to save yourself a few dollars. All right, now let's dive right in. So, being known for its managed WordPress services, along with its hosting application and database services, Kinsta is actually a pretty well-known name when it comes to cloud hosting platforms. Now, I want to get started with the most important factor of any cloud hosting platform, their security. With their included Cloudflare integration, that comes with DDoS protection. It protects your data with a solid firewall while also boosting site performance with HTTP3 support and C2 compute optimized VMs. So the websites hosted by them can work smoothly even with bigger amounts of traffic and constant clicking between pages. They also do regular malware scans on the servers, automatic daily backups, uptime monitoring, and more. So along with the monitoring, you can just focus on building your website and business whilst Kinsta does all the rest. But they don't just focus on security, their performance is actually also pretty solid. Like I mentioned earlier, there shouldn't be any lagging between pages, clicks, or even animations on your website, since it's built off of Google's cloud platform's premium tier network and C2 machines. Kinsta actually provides a 99.99% uptime guarantee. And if the servers are ever down for longer than that, then you'll get some credit to use towards your next billing. During the 4 months I've been using Kinsta, that actually hasn't happened. And looking into their performance stats, their uptime stays at a consistent 100%. And their speed is averaged around 2 seconds of loading time, which is even better than Google's recommendation for a standard of 3 seconds. Now on the back end, I found Kinsta very convenient to handle all my projects in one place with their WordPress hosting. Now if you use WordPress, then Kinsta is actually a solid choice to host your website, since it was designed with WordPress in mind as a website builder. All the tools, data transfers, security, and everything else in between are designed for the duo. Personally, I prefer to use Kinsta for my WordPress websites over other hosting platforms. I like their simple interface. It has pretty much everything I need without a bunch of useless tools like some similar platforms that I've tried out in the past. I'm also not having to click through a bunch of tabs and tools to find what I want, which is nice too. Obviously, I suggest that you use whatever CMS you're most comfortable with. WordPress is not for everyone, but personally, I really like it. Now, whenever I made the switch from my previous host to Kinsta, I definitely saw a bit of improvement in speed, even if Kinsta is slightly more expensive, so I could kind of see what I was paying for already. But speaking of the price, I kind of like the way their billing works with their application and database hosting. It's basically like an electricity bill. You use a certain amount of resources, and that's added up at the end of the month. Then you pay. Pretty straightforward, right? And if you have a personal website or blog, I'd recommend you just stick with the starter plan. For smaller businesses, you can use the pro plan, since there's usually no need for more than 2 websites unless you're planning to expand. Now, if you own or work for a larger business and are looking into Kinsta, you probably already know which plan and features you'll need. But if you're unsure, you can talk to their team directly. I actually contacted them when I thought about upgrading my plan so I could start another online store. And the guy I talked to was super helpful, very friendly, no issues there at all. But there were also some issues I ran into. What I don't like much about their services is the fact that you don't get unlimited visits to your website. But I guess they do allow a large number. Their cheapest plan allows 25,000 visits. I'd still like to see that change to unlimited. And if you don't want to use WordPress CMS for your WordPress website, Kinsta is not for you, since that's the only one they allow. But if you don't use WordPress, this doesn't really matter that much, I guess. But considering that Kinsta markets itself as a top-of-the-line hosting provider for WordPress and doesn't actually offer email hosting either, was pretty surprising to me. So if you want to do email hosting, you'll have to pay for a separate service. So this would definitely add some extra cost on top of the Kinsta hosting bill, which is not exactly the cheapest, but I do think that the quality of their hosting platform justifies the price. And if you want to save some money on your monthly hosting bill, definitely take advantage of that discount link in the description below this video. It will take you straight through to their website with the discount link already applied for you automatically. All right, now if you've made it this far, thanks very much for watching. Let me know if you have any questions by writing them in the comments below. Don't forget to thumbs up and subscribe, and I'll maybe see you next time. Thanks.